morning, York School. Mr. D here. Awesome. We got an awesome assembly lineup today. We got a special friend of the York School today, Vince Luciani, who's with us. He's the founder of the Legacy Coaching. It works with individuals inside and outside the arena of sport, essentially taking them on a journey to find the best version of themselves. And he really focuses on some core values: truth, love, space, and guided discovery. Phenomenal individual. He's been on an amazing journey himself. Varsity football player at Wilfrid Laurier University. Took that passion for football, entered the coaching arena at Ohio University in the NCAA, which is an amazing accomplishment. And he just kind of has continued on this journey of wanting to help people out so that they can find the best version of themselves. He works with some amazing athletes such as Iggy Bradzdakis of the New York Knicks. He's been to our school a couple times to speak to parents, but this is the first time that he's coming to talk to our student body, and we're super lucky to have him. He's one of those people that is just like, I mean, I can't say enough about him, but he's a straight up legend. We have guest speakers all the time, but this is a really great opportunity. Take some knowledge from him, take some learning from him today, and let's enjoy what he has to say. So I'm going to pass it off to my guy, my boy, Vince, and let's lock in. Thank you.
Thanks, Rick. It's awesome. Hi, everyone. As Rick mentioned, I'm Vince. And to keep this really simple, I'm going to give you 5 tips on how to love your legacy. So love is the word that's going to pop up a lot throughout this presentation. And I know you're probably thinking, like, what does love have to do with sport? That's what I'm going to teach you today. So my journey is like Rick said, I was always an athlete. I always defined myself as an athlete. And I actually hid behind the identity of being an athlete. And what I did was I focused on football. I played 5 years at Laurier, got into coaching in the CFL, coaching in the NCAA. And then I further solidified the identity and the label of being a coach. And what ended up happening was I had a knee injury in Ohio, and I ruptured my patella tendon in my left knee. And then I had to come home to recover. And in coming home to recover, I got hired at Lululemon. So put up your hand if you know Lululemon. Just kidding, I can't see you. I know I can't see if you put up your hand. But I got hired at Lululemon, and within a week of getting hired, my manager sat me down and asked me, Vince, who are you? And I was like, oh, I'm a football coach. And she said, no, that's just what you are. Who are you? And I actually broke down in tears, and I started crying in this coffee shop, because my whole life I put up these walls, I put up these labels, I put up these titles to protect me from understanding, from others understanding who I truly was inside. So I founded the Legacy Coaching, and what I do is I help athletes understand what it means to be more than an athlete. Because we hear it a lot, you're more than an athlete. But when I ask athletes, well, who are you? A lot of them go, I don't know. So I'm going to teach you a few tricks and a few tips to understand that. But I want you to think about this question right now. Who are you without your sport? And then if you go, oh, well, I'm a brother, who are you without being a brother? Who are you without being a sister? Who are you without, you know, being a student? Who are you without all of those things? And it's a really scary thought, but this is where we start to understand who we truly are. So I'm going to tell you a story about how the athlete identity is formed. I was coaching my 4-year-old cousin's soccer game, and there were, you know, parents were showing up with their chairs. The kids were putting on their jerseys backwards. It was just a pure moment. And while I started coaching, I had a kid picking dandelions like they do. I had another kid over here hugging his opponent in the middle of the game. And then I had we had a breakaway, and we kicked the ball, and we completely missed. And sure enough, the goalie on the other team picked up the little net and moved it over just so that we would score. And so I started to observe. They were just playing for the love of the game. And as the game went on, these same kids were getting really upset. And I noticed that they were getting upset because parents weren't cheering for them unless they were kicking or scoring. And you got to think about this. I work with a lot of pro athletes who have played their entire life for the love of others, not from the love of their self. So think about this. There's playing for others, which is I'm playing so that I can impress my friends. I'm playing so I can impress my parents. And that's the love that they are giving me. Or you could play from the love of yourself, which is, what am I giving myself? And the goal is to be right in between both. Okay, so it's understanding that the love you're getting from others is also the love you can give to yourself. Now, how to make this practical, I'm going to give you a few tools. So what we want to break this down to is, your sport is not everything. And I know a lot of you are sitting there like, what do you mean? This is what I've been doing my whole life. Your sport is not everything. You are everything within and without your sport. So think about that for a second. While you're playing the sport, you're everything. You're whole and complete. You're full of love. When you're out of your sport, same thing. You're the exact same. What happens is we get caught up in, when I win, I'm a really good person. When I lose, I'm a really bad person. Okay? So here's one thing that I fully believe in. The answer is always love. Okay? So when you celebrate only your success, so when you win and you celebrate yourself, everything's good, I feel awesome about myself, and I don't celebrate my failure, that's conditional love. That means I only love myself when things are good. But when you also celebrate your failures, that's unconditional love. Now, with this, I know a lot of you are sitting there and going, well, what do you mean? Like, if I lose, I'm supposed to feel good about it? No, it's not about feeling good about the loss, but it's about feeling good about yourself and knowing that your win or your loss doesn't mean anything about you. So after a game or after a practice, you didn't have a good practice, it's not going, I suck. It's going, okay, maybe I can be better in my performance, but I don't suck. I am good enough. I am enough. I am loved. So, and the thing with celebrating failure is, you gotta think, when we fail, do we learn? And the answer is yes. I hope some of you are nodding your heads. When we learn, do we grow? The answer is yes. When we grow, do we get closer to success? The answer is yes. So why would we not celebrate failure? It brings us closer to the thing that we want most. So think about that. And I know a lot of you, as athletes, we're very hard on ourselves. And that opportunity right there is when failure happens. We're hard on ourselves. We're hard on ourselves when we fail. But now what I want you to try to, you know, even throughout this pandemic, when you screw up in something, whether it's an online course, whether it's, you know, whether you're training, be nice to yourself. Be like, it's okay. We've got this. So tip two, beware of your attachments. And when I think of attachments, it's the things that you are connected to, you're attached to. Okay. So for me, it was always my sport. And what I mean by attachment, it's when this thing goes up, I go up. So when I win, Vince wins. I feel really good about Vince. When I lose, I feel really crappy about Vince. Okay? If it's a relationship, when my girlfriend says, Vince, I love you, I feel loved. When she doesn't say I love you, I don't feel loved. That means I'm attached to those things. Okay? So I'll show you an example using Instagram, because a lot of us use Instagram, or TikTok, whatever is your favorite. But what the way it works is, this is you right here, okay? And the vehicle of you accessing this love is Instagram. Okay, so when we get likes, follows, comments, okay, how do we feel? And the answer usually is, I'm accepted, or I'm loved. Okay, now the way to hijack this is to go, before I post on Instagram, it's not about not posting on Instagram. Before I post on Instagram, do I feel loved on my own? Like, I love myself. So this is the thing about, it's like, you know, when I was your age, I'd wear an outfit and I'd be like, yo guys, what do you think of my shirt? And so I would look for the love from everyone else and not from myself. It wasn't like, oh, I love this shirt, I'm going to wear it. It was more, hey, what do you guys think about what I'm wearing? Hey, did you see that shot I made? Hey, did you see the catch I made? Did you see the goal? We're either living for others and getting the love of others, or we're living for and coming from the love of ourselves. So tip three is, watch your language. Now, this is obviously, don't swear, but your language in terms of how you speak about yourself. You know, how many of you, and again, I can't see your hands, but I just want you to think about it. speak poorly of yourselves when you screw up. It's like, yeah, but I'm not good enough. Yeah, but I'm not capable of doing that. Yeah, but this isn't possible. Yeah, but I've never done that before. I've never shot a three-pointer before. I've never kicked a ball that far. Everything after I am is the truth. So if I say I'm a bad driver, what am I going to be? I'm going to be a bad driver. But if I say I'm getting better at driving, it's still the truth. Okay, so the idea is to really focus on what are you saying after the words I am. And again, to make it very practical, when you're texting your friends, and if you say I am miserable, or I hate this, or I suck, those are all true because you made them true. So I encourage you just to become aware of your language. It's not about that's wrong, that's right. It's just to be aware of it. Because chances are when you look at how you speak about yourself, when you look at it, you're going to go, I don't want to speak about myself like that. So it's really becoming aware of how you speak about you, because it creates your reality. It creates whatever's happening around you. Because if I believe that I am loving, if I believe that I'm loved, if I believe that I'm lovable, I will attract things that reflect that. So this is the difference here, because I know a lot of you are like, well, if I suck, then I suck. So, am I going to lie to myself? There's limiting language. So limiting language is I am slow. Limiting means I can be nothing else than slow. That's it. I've put myself in a box. Now, empowering language and opening it up is I can be faster. Do you see how I said the exact same thing, but in a positive framing? So I can be faster, it's limitless. I can just keep getting faster. But I am slow, I've limited myself to always being slow. So one of my favorite ways to do this is, you know, when I tell you that your love either comes from others or it comes from yourself, go to a mirror, and I know a lot of you, you know, you have siblings, you may have parents, guardians. So it may be weird to do this, okay? But I'm going to tell you, it's going to be weird, but it's going to be the best thing for you. I want you to look at yourself in the mirror and not looking at you, looking in, like looking through your eyes, okay? And when you look through your eyes, I want you to speak to yourself the way you always want people to speak to you. So if it's, you're awesome, it's like, Vince, you're awesome. If it's, you're amazing. If it's, you can do anything you want. If it's, I love you, I'm proud of you. I want you to look in the mirror and say those things and watch what happens. A lot of us get really uncomfortable. Like one of my clients who's an Olympian, she did this and she was like, it was weird. I started crying. I couldn't do it. I walked away. I came back. But the idea is it's uncomfortable because we've never looked in for our love. We've always looked out for our love. So this is one thing you could just take with you today and literally go to the bathroom, look in the mirror and go, you're awesome, and watch what happens. Tip 4 is practice stillness. And when I say stillness, it's not sitting there cross-legged. It's not sitting there cross-legged and going, you know, focusing on your breath. I'm talking stillness like turn your phone off, no music, nothing, close your door, be with yourself, be with your feelings. Because the majority of what we're experiencing in this quarantine, there's a lot of uncomfortable feelings. What I encourage you to do is sit with those feelings. If you need to cry, cry. And we'll get to that later in expressing emotion. But when we sit with ourselves, when we sit in stillness, we're sitting with ourselves. So when someone says, I have trouble sitting still, and I know a lot of us do as teenagers, and I do as well. But when we have trouble sitting still, what we're actually saying is I have trouble sitting with myself. Next is authentically express yourself. So I look at this, like everybody knows Super Mario and the green pipes in Super Mario. Sometimes Super Mario can go in the pipe and sometimes he can't. And you are this pipe. Sometimes we're really blocked with emotion and with tension, and sometimes we're open. And the idea is I want you to practice being open and expressing so that everything can flow through your pipe. So I'm going to give you some tips for expression. First is it's always okay to cry. When I was a little boy, I was very sensitive, emotional, compassionate. I cried a lot, but I was taught that boys aren't supposed to cry. I was taught that you're not supposed to cry in sports. You're not supposed to cry at school. You're not supposed to cry. I want you to know that it is important to cry. And now the thing with expressing emotion and anything like this is it's like going to the bathroom. It's got to be done in a safe place. Okay. So it's not about going in the hallway and well, I know we're in quarantine, but it's not about going in the hallway and just crying all over the place, but create time and space for you to express that emotion. Because if it's not coming out here, it's staying in here. And it's a whole other story, but I suppressed so much emotion that I had the world's largest splenic cyst on my stomach. It was removed. Don't worry. Next is express your truth. So this is what do others want me to say? And then what do I truly want to say? And what you truly want to say, it's like a ball of yarn sitting in your chest. And every time you speak, a new thread comes out. Okay? You all know the feeling when you're sitting in a conversation, your friend says something you completely disagree with, but you keep it in. What I want you to do is practice saying how you truly feel. Feel. Not what you truly think, what you truly feel. Because your body won't lie to you. Allow yourself to feel. And I know in sport we're taught like, oh, don't cry. Everything's going to be okay. Allow yourself to feel. When you lose, it doesn't mean, oh, we lost. Everything's fine. You can be upset, but come back to being present in the moment. When you win, you can celebrate, but come back to being in the present moment. Because what happens is when we get carried away with either, we get carried away from being who we truly are. The last story I'll leave you with is be yourself. Be you. And this is Tom Brady's life coach. And the story I tell about this is I reach out to him over the phone and I said, hey, Greg, I'd love to chat with you. I want to pick your brain. He's like, yeah, we'll set up a phone call. I was like, no, I'll drive down to you in Michigan for that 15 minutes. He's like, all right, I'll give you 2 hours if you take me out to lunch. So I take him out to lunch. I go down to Michigan and it's really uncomfortable. He's like, he's expecting something. He's uncomfortable. He's kind of like, oh, like, I don't know what this guy wants. So it was really awkward, and I'm not an awkward guy. I love these chats, okay? We sit down at lunch, and he's still being very short with me, and I love puns. So the server came over with hummus with an olive on it, and she slides it on the table. And I said, and I was like, okay, this is my chance. This is the only time I can be myself. I was like, excuse me, do you want us to have some of this or all of it? And she didn't get the joke, but he was losing it. And after that, he just opened right up, and he was like, Vince, what do you want to know? You're hilarious. I love what you're doing. And we had this 2-hour conversation just because I was willing to be myself. And the thing I'll say about that is when you are yourself, you will attract things that reflect who you truly are. Not just things. You'll attract people. You'll attract opportunities. When you're playing sports, you'll be more free and more present if you're truly yourself. So the 5 tips, just to go over them, the answer is always love. Everything that we want, it's always love. So you might as well give it to yourself first. Be aware of your attachments. So what are the things that you're relying on to feel good about you? Watch your language. Everything after I am is the truth. So watch what you say about you. 4, practice stillness. So be with yourself. 5, express yourself. When you truly feel something, say it, express it, feel it. So to sum all this up, this is how to live into your sport is not everything. You are everything within and without your sport. And this is how to love your legacy, because by loving your legacy, all you're doing is loving you. Thanks for having me, everyone. I really appreciate it. Thanks for listening.
Awesome. I just want to take a moment. Unbelievable presentation by Vince. I think that, we made a lot of reference to sport. But I think that this is applicable in the game of life for anything that you do, whether it's your passions in arts or whatever. It applies to an approach to life. So just with the pun thing, I want to give Vince a big hand here and a high five. But thank you so much, Vince, for taking time out of your day. We hope to obviously see you in person at some point when we're back at school so you can keep enlightening us and inspiring us with your passion. So thank you very much for taking time.
Thank you for having me.
Hey, York. The faculty has come together to create a message that celebrates the rich and vibrant community we are all a part of here at the York School. In March, Mr. Hamilton rewrote the lyrics to the Beatles classic, Hey Jude. a song known for its comforting and uplifting message. As we continue to be physically apart, we hope that this song and the memories shared provide some comfort and remind us that we are not alone.
Hey, yo.
And now for our announcements.
Hey York, I'm here outside with my son Freezer practicing up for our annual tire derby. Final house challenge. You ready, Freezer?
Mom, give it a rest. There's gonna be no tire derby this year, okay?
Okay.
Hey York, we are having our final house challenge next week on Wednesday, May 20th during assembly. Remember, this is your last challenge, so anything can happen. For this house challenge, we are bringing you all a blast from the past with an awesome and hilarious Guess That Teacher's Childhood Photo Quiz. Get ready for some shockers and get excited to see all our amazing teachers as kids. On the slide here, we have our awesome high school principal, Mr. Hamilton, and Mr. Robertson, our head of school, as a great example. You'll be competing in your house family groups and filling out the quiz form. We will meet using the live stream link and then go off to our house family Google Meets from there. Stay tuned for more information, but in the meantime, get excited. Thanks, York.
Come and meet the candidates running for house head in the senior school and house captain in the middle school at our first ever virtual house hangout. Ask them questions and witness the spirit that they will need to lead your house to victory next year. Next Wednesday, May 20th at 1 p.m., come and meet the candidates running for Simcoe and Johnson. And on Thursday, May 21st at 1 p.m., meet the candidates for Househead from both Champlain and McClung. The Househead and Homeroom Representative campaign slides are live for viewing. Click on the links in the senior loop to check out the candidates running for these leadership positions. Voting will take place for Househeads and Grade 10 Homeroom Reps on Friday, May 22nd from 8:50 to 10:30 a.m. If you are in grade 10, you will only vote for students in your advisor group. And if there are more than two candidates running for Househead, a vote will take place from members in that house only. All results will be shared at 5 p.m.
Hi, middle school. I just wanted to update you on our current leadership positions, as well as a new opportunity for those individuals that are looking for some leadership in the middle school in the 2020-2021 school year. The first thing is, if you applied to be a grade 8 leader, your slides are due this Friday to Ms. Rowell, and you need to make sure that you're signing up for an interview time. If you are a house captain, please make sure that you're signing up for an interview time, but also note that the Google Hangouts have changed. If you are part of Simcoe or Johnson, you're meeting on May 20th, and if you're part of Champlain or McClung, you're meeting on May 21st. The other opportunity that has come up is to be an ambassador next year for the 2020-2021 school year. If you are a current grade 6 or grade 7 student and you'd like another leadership opportunity, being an ambassador might be for you. An email has been sent to you directly, and if you misplace that, then the link is also in the middle school loop. This is just a reminder for all students in the middle school. We're still looking for students to write a resident. We have the Amica Bell Morrill Seniors Residence right by school, and we're trying to create a community reach out program to those individuals as they're separated from their loved ones and families. If you're interested, there is a slide deck on Blackboard going through all of the steps that are required, or you could just email Ms. Rowell.
Following last week's assembly on Service in Action, here's another initiative that you can take part in as a Your School student.
Ocean Hero is a search engine like Google, but this one saves the environment. Ocean Hero pays individuals in need to remove plastic from the ocean. For every 5 searches made on this engine, 1 plastic bottle is removed from the ocean.
There has already been over 3 million bottles removed from the ocean. The more you search, the more plastic is removed.
Download on the Chrome Web Store now as a free extension. Get Ocean Hero.
Special thanks to everyone in the middle school who has created artwork and sent it to the Kids Care Project, started by Max Bordeaux in grade 4. He shared with me over the weekend that he has already sent out 272 pieces of artwork to raise people's spirits at hospitals, seniors' residences around the GTA. He feels he has more work to do, but wanted to say thanks.
Hi, thank you guys so much for doing this. It means so much to me.
This is just a heads up about the Middle School Recognition Assembly that will happen on Tuesday, May 26th for grades 6 to 8. This is the last assembly before closing ceremonies on June 12th. Why should you join us on YLCC Online? We know that in this uncertain time, lots of us are trying to find some sort of routine and consistency. The YLCC Youth Leadership Camps Canada are bringing what they've been doing for the past 30 years at Summer Camp in the Woods online. Join virtual campfires, morning opportunities to journal and set goals, daily challenges, science experiments, crafts, dance parties, and so much more. They are building an online community where you can connect and feel like you belong. It doesn't matter if you've been to YLCC 100 times or 0 times. You are welcome to join the fun. They hang out Monday through Friday at 10:30 a.m., 3:30 p.m., and 8 o'clock p.m. All you need to do is click the link on the slide in the loop to join the call and be part of something awesome. Thanks again to our inspiring guest speaker, Vince Luciani. It was an amazing talk this morning. We hope to see everyone next week at Assembly for our final house challenge. We will all meet together to hear the instructions, and then you will head to your house family Google Meets to interact and work together at your last chance to earn points to win the House Cup. Have a great day, York.